friends, welcome to another episode of Delicacies on the Plate. Today I'm going to make a paneer dish, and that is paneer pasanda. Yes guys, this is very delicious and very tasty. Especially when you stuff the dry fruits in between the paneer, it tastes very rich. To make the stuffing for paneer pasanda, I'm using a tablespoon of finely chopped cashews, finely chopped almonds, few raisins, finely chopped coriander around 1 tablespoon, few mint leaves which I have finely chopped, this is 3 to 4. 1 green chili which I have finely chopped, grated paneer, this is cottage cheese which I have grated. Now first I'll slice up this cottage cheese into thin slices. I'll roast the dry fruits, the raisins, the cashews and the almonds in 1 teaspoon of oil. Now in 1 teaspoon of oil, I'll just roast the almonds, cashews and raisins. Raisins will start to swell up. Then I'll remove it from the pan. You can see the dry fruits are well roasted. Now I'll mix all the stuffing ingredients. In this I'll add the chili, the mint leaves, the coriander leaves and I'll mix it well. And just a pinch of salt. Now here the stuffing ingredients are mixed well. I'll keep this on side. Now to coat the cottage cheese, I have taken 1 to 1.5 tablespoon of corn flour and 1 to 1.5 tablespoon of plain flour in equal quantities. I'll mix this and I'll make a paste of it. I'll just add a pinch of salt. Water. Now here I'll stuff the cheese slices with the stuffing. In this way I'll prepare all the cheese stuff. Now I'll slowly dip the stuffed cheese slices into the solution. I'll coat it and then I'll fry it on the pan. Once the whole block of paneer, stuffed paneer slices are fried, cut it into half and then diagonally and then fry the open side. So I'll now start preparing the gravy. To make the gravy, I'm using around 2 medium size of onion, around 7 to 8 garlic cloves, 1/2 teaspoon of grated ginger, 3 to 4 cloves, 2 small cardamom, 2 to 3 pieces of cinnamon stick, 1 bay leaf which I have broken into pieces, 1 red chili for spiciness and 1 red chili for color, 3 tomatoes, around 10 to 12 cashews, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/4 teaspoon of coriander powder and cumin seeds for tadka. And finally, salt for taste. Now I'll start to heat up a saucepan. I'll add around 4 to 5 tablespoon of oil. Add around 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Let it splutter. Once the cumin seeds splutter, add all the dry spices first. The red chilies, the bay leaf, the cloves, the cinnamon stick, the small cardamom, everything, let it splutter. Then add the garlic. I'm adding as a whole because it is going to all be grinded in the grinder. Add the cashews. The dry spices powder, roast it for around 30 seconds, add the tomatoes and again cook till the tomato gets tender. Now the masala is well fried, I'll let it cool and then I'll grind it in the grinder and then I'll pass it through a strainer, I'll strain it. Now the mixture has cooled quite nicely, so I'll now grind this. Now I'll pass it through the strainer. You can see the gravy is so creamy. I'll simmer this again for 5 minutes and then I'll pour it over the stuffed paneer slices. Garnish the gravy with 1 tablespoon of fresh cream. Pour the gravy over the stuffed cheese slices. The paneer basanda is ready. Serve it with roti, naan. It will taste very nice. Garnish with freshly chopped coriander. It is ready to serve. If you have liked this video, click on like and share and subscribe for more delicious recipes and delicacies on the plate. You're welcome to share your unique recipes and make it popular through this channel.